Welcome to River Tech and to our annual Christmas production. We are so excited. River Tech is mostly known for our technology classes like coding and robotics and digital design and digital arts and 3D modeling. But we actually also have a pretty good arts program. The kids learn to play instruments, they learn to sing, to draw, to act. And apropos acting, and without further ado, I am proud to introduce you to Annie. Let's give it up.
The time is 1933. We're smack dab in the middle of Great Depression in the city of New York. It's 4 a.m. at the New York City orphanage.
Annie, what are you doing? Running away. Annie, you're crazy. Miss Hannigan will catch you.
I don't care. I'm getting out of here. I gotta find my parents. Pepper, take care of Molly for me.
Shh.
Mama, mommy.
Quiet.
Mama, mommy.
I said zip it, Molly.
Stop throwing the poor kid.
She's keeping me awake, ain't she?
No, you're keeping us.
You want to make something out of it?
How about I make a pancake out of you?
Oh my goodness. I'm fighting again. I won't get no sleep all night.
Pipe down, all of you. It's all right, Molly. Annie's here.
It was my mommy, Annie. I lost her. And I couldn't find her no more.
Blo, it was only a dream. Now you gotta go back to sleep. It's after 3 o'clock.
Annie, read me your note.
Again?
Please?
Sure, Molly.
Here it comes again.
Please take good care of our little darling. Her name is Annie.
She was born on October 28th. We'll be back to get her soon.
So that when we come back for her, you'll know that she's our baby.
Gee, I dream about having a mother and a father again, but you're lucky. You really got him.
Aha! Caught you! Everybody up. Annie here was trying to run away again, and as a little welcome home present, everyone gets to clean.
But it's the middle of the night!
I don't care. Make this sun shine like the top of the Chrysler Building.
Treated, we get tricked, sent to see us, we get kicked. It's a hard knock life.
Hey, little girl, have you seen any street dogs around here?
No, sir.
Good, then. They must be running wild a few streets over. Get inside before you catch a cold.
Oh, I'm all right, sir. The cold doesn't bother me. Oh, there's one they didn't get. They're after you, aren't they? Well, they're after me, too. But don't worry, I'm not going to let them get you or me. Everything's going to be fine for the both of us. You'll see.
The sun will come out tomorrow, so you gotta hang on to tomorrow. There'll be some just thinking about tomorrow. Clears away the cobwebs and the sorrow. Till there's none when it's over.
Lieutenant Ward took Annie back to the orphanage.
Little girls everywhere. Turn, I can see them. Little girls, night and day, I eat, sleep, and breathe them.
Get out of here!
I should be anywhere but here. On stage, private planes, TV. But I find myself here at this hot house.
Little shoes, little socks, please kill me. I'm serious, please kill me. I'm not singing, I'm asking.
Locked in a cage with all the rats, I slipped through the cracks, and now I'm stuck with the scraps, and I can't seem to find my way. Get me out of here. I'll get around, I'm ready for stardom after all these years. I'm done with little girls. I want to be someone in this world. Little girls everywhere I turn, I can see them.
get out of here.
Yes, I wanna tear my hair out. I should be famous, a part of history. But I find myself here at this snot house. Little shoes, little socks. Please kill me, I'm serious. Please kill me, I'm not singing, I'm asking. Locked in a cage with all the rats, I slipped through the cracks, and now I'm stuck with the scraps that I can't see to find my way back. Get me out of here. Throw me a rope, I'm looking for stardom. After all these years, I'm done with little girls. I wanna be someone in this world. Little girls.
Trying to decide how to punish Annie, the orphanage received an unusual visitor.
Hello, I'm looking for Miss Hannigan.
Yes, I'm Miss Hannigan. Who are you?
I'm Grace Federal, private secretary to Mr. Stacks.
Mr. Stacks the millionaire?
No, Mr. Stacks the billionaire. Mr. Stacks has decided to invite an orphan to stay at his home for the Christmas holidays.
Okay. What sort of orphan did he have in mind? I can be ready in 5 minutes.
Let's see. Mr. Stacks had a child in mind. She should be friendly and cheerful. And, oh, I almost forgot. Mr. Stacks prefers curly hair children.
A cheerful curly head? No, we don't have any of those.
But Grace insisted that Annie be the chosen orphan, and Annie was off to Mr. Stack's mansion.
Good afternoon, Miss Farrow.
Good afternoon, Drake.
May I take your coats?
Will I get it back?
Of course, Annie, anytime you want it. Everyone, this is Annie and her dog, Sandy. Annie, this is everyone.
Hi, everyone.
Annie, what do you want to do first?
The floors. I'll scrub them. Then I'll start on the windows.
Annie, you won't have to do any cleaning. You're our guest.
And for the next 2 weeks, you'll have a swell time here. Now let me explain how it works.
I think I'm gonna like it here.
There you are. Hello, everybody. Drake, dismiss the staff. Everyone has worked hard getting ready for Annie to visit. Grace and I can handle things from here.
Yes, sir.
Well, Annie, we ought to do something special on your first night. Would you like to go to a movie?
Gosh, Mr. Sachs, I've never been to one.
Drake?
Yes, sir.
Get on coach. We're going to the movies.
Leaping Lizards.
Which car are you wanting, sir?
Annie has been cooped up in an orphanage. We'll walk.
It's nice of you to drop by.
Good evening. It's nice to be here.
Mr. Stacks, I understand you have something to tell the folks at home about little Annie here.
Yes, I am now conducting a coast-to-coast nationwide search for Annie's parents and offering a certified check for $50,000 to any persons who can prove that they are Annie's parents.
So, Annie's parents, if you're listening, write to Mr. Stacks, care of the station, until next week, same time, same station, same smiles. Good night.
I wish I was on the radio.
Me too.
Who wants to be in the dumb radio?
I do for all the hours of Smiles Family is the best. This is Bird Healy saying.
What are you doing up?
Andy was on the radio.
Yeah, I heard it. $50,000. What I couldn't do with $50,000. I just got an idea. Hello? Rooster? How'd you like to make enough money to get out of this dump? What am I doing? This is not who I am.
I'm not afraid of the dark.
And Shirley Mudge.
And you're our Annie Mudge.
Annie Mudge?
We loved you, Annie, but we had to leave you behind.
We've seen a great number of people who...
I expect you'll be wanting proof of who we are. Ralph. There's Annie's birth certificate and our driving licenses.
Ralph, look, Annie is wearing the locket.
When we left Annie, we gave her half a silver locket and kept the other half.
Ralph, she's our Annie.
Stop!
Lieutenant Ward!
Mr. Stacks, I've had the police station tracing Annie's parents, David and Margaret Bennett. Unfortunately, they've passed away. These people are frauds. Louise, turn them over. And Annie, what should we do with Miss Hannigan? It seems she's had a change of heart. She used to be mean, but now she really does want to help the children.
Miss Hannigan deserves a second chance, just like I got. Not knowing what I've had in front of me has been a problem of mine for a long time, but I'm learning.
Me too.
Annie, I want to adopt you. What do you think? Could you live with me?
If I can't have my real mother and father, there's no one else in the world I'd rather have for a dad than you, Mr. Stacks.
This was the beginning of many adventures for our little orphan Annie. The nation may have been depressed that Christmas of 1933, but Annie gave whoever she met, rich or poor, the gift of hope and goodwill.
Together at last, together forever, we're time and not it's ever.
Yeah.
just thinking about.